of running back that they face for you guys, especially up front?
You know, we hit on this a little bit last week. It seems like all of a sudden everybody's going back to the big bruising, big giant offensive lines, 270-pound fullbacks, 250-pound tailbacks. And we got a dose of him a little bit last year. And early in the year, they didn't seem like they were doing what they're doing now. I mean, they were doing it, but this last four or five games, they've really kind of accelerated and gotten to another level. And, some of their run concepts are extremely tough to stop because they add so many people to the point of attack, similar like Wisconsin used to. And I had a steady dose of them back in the day. So it's some great challenges, and especially for us because, you know, since we've been a 4-2-5 to combat the spread concepts, size-wise, we do need to, go back and rethink our schedule and how many teams they're doing like what Miami's doing enough, and obviously Pitt. And so, and pounding the rock. So we need to kind of rethink some stuff.
How much have you had to adjust your scheme this week? Have you moved any more guys up on the line?
Yes and no. Yes, we've adjusted to match what they do, but no, we've kind of gotten to a place since early in the season where we couldn't do a bunch of stuff, even with an open day. So we're trying to stay within our package that some of our younger guys, of which we're playing a ton of, that they got a chance to be successful. And, so, we're trying to kind of stay within the framework of our stuff. But, in all honesty, we had lengthy talks back that first Sunday after Miami about who do we have that we can put down and play them. There wasn't an answer, there were some ideas and suggestions, but there wasn't an answer. So, we've tried to kind of match what we do as best we can to what they're going to do.
Does it help at all having just gone up against Duke Johnson and seeing what a style like that will do to this team?
Yeah, Duke Johnson will outrun everybody you got, obviously, for 90 yards. And, if you take that one run out, it was fairly competitive as far as holding them a number of yards on. You can't take that one run out. But, Now we've got, a defensive end playing tailback, and then five and some of the other guys get in there. I mean, they're still 220, 225 going against, sub 200 pound, Rams and corners, and they get on the edge. And then again, they can throw the ball really well. Their pass concepts make it almost impossible to load the box too much.
With Pitt changing, as you said, through the course of the year, being much more run-oriented the last four or five games.
Yes.
Is that a result of them having a lot of success with it? Or maybe they weren't having some success in the other areas and they kind of narrowed their focus?
That's probably a better question for staff. I hate to speculate on that. I think that
does it give you confidence?
Good players, they've got good players. We are trying everything known to man to build confidence. You brought that word up, I think, what you were saying, build, to give you confidence, to get our guys to be confident in what they're doing and confident in themselves and confident in everything we're doing. And so that's been a big part of our preparation for Pitt, is to try to do things that they feel like they can be successful doing.
Do you feel like if you do slow the run some, it gives you guys a pretty sizable advantage?
Well, that's we're going to have to, because they're just going to sit there and do it and wait the clock. Last year, they kind of fell into this, some of the stuff that they did, and that running back, that was really his first kind of coming out party. So we know what he's capable of, and he's at a different level right now. He looked like a 240 Red Grange last game. So,
how do you go about building confidence with things?
Well, I always thought that coaches couldn't give players confidence. I mean, I think you can, but you can show them what they've done well, and then that, then they get confident in being successful. So if a player doesn't play well, or he doesn't prepare well, or he's not into it, a coach can't trick him and tell him, hey, you know, it's all right, you're good, it's all right, you can, you gain confidence by doing the small things well, and then you go to the next level things well, and build on that. And I think that's what we've been kind of trying to do, is go back to, doing every little bitty thing well, and then kind of build on that. So.